So this brings me to the last item on the Hour of Kwonmunism. And as is usual, the last thing I talk about is personal. And in this, you know, Hour of Kwonmunism number 4, I'll talk about, I guess, I'll try to answer this question, like, how did you get started on YouTube, or, you know, what's the history here? And so it's interesting because YouTube is actually the social media account that I have. It's one of the longest running. I think it's the oldest one I have. It's older than my Facebook. It's older than my Twitter, definitely. Older than, I think, even my Gmail. Actually, I think I had a Yahoo email account. And then I abandoned that, got onto Gmail. And then, but I had a YouTube account before that. And I honestly, like, when I first started on YouTube, like, first got a YouTube account, I didn't really bother with it too much. I just wanted it to have it so I can comment on a couple of videos that I watched. I like the blogs a lot. People who like this, you know, talk in front of the camera, but edit out the uhs and the boring moments and kind of just, you know, splice together all the moments where the person talks really fast or something like that. I liked Happy Feet and I liked Community Channel. Those are the two YouTubers that I regularly watched. And I like them so much. I like these kind of blogs, the idea of regular people talking in front of the camera and creating, you know, telling their stories and sharing their life and sharing their creativity so much that I wanted to get involved. I started with just commenting and stuff, and I realized, like, you know, I have this love of video games, and I, most of the time, I was writing a lot. I was a big writer on GameTrailers.com. They had a different section for users where they can write their own blogs, share, you know, be on forums and stuff. I was kind of a really big part of that. And so I did that a lot. And then I thought, you know, I want to make a video of me doing this. And the first video I think I ever really uploaded was, I don't quite remember. I can kind of go back into it. Should have done the research before this, but that's the thing with this Art of Communism videos, it's just that I just talk for an hour. But you guys can correct me later. But I believe it was like me uploading, I was playing Nobi Nobi Boy, which is this really, really weird game made by the creators of Katamari Damacy. But it's this super weird game where you just gulp up stuff and you just stretch out long and long and long with this little, like a, it looks like a, I don't know, long wiener dog. Wiener Schnitzel dog, and there is this ability in that game to upload whatever, you know, record gameplay footage and just upload it straight to YouTube. I think that's one of my very first videos. I can't say if that was, I'm not exactly sure if that was my first video, but that's kind of how it started. And then, you know, I had all these reviews that I've written up. And blogs that I've written up, and I thought, like, this would be really great to share also in video form. And I share them a lot in the GameTrailers.com website, their user video sections. And then I started slowly transferring them over to YouTube. The videos I made were really crude, because I didn't have, like, a video camera. I didn't have a MacBook with the ability to do this, to talk in front of the camera, was not available to me at the time. I didn't have that ability at the time. So it was mostly just like screenshot videos or slideshows. You know, I would have images that I would take from different websites and from Google Images, and I would just compile them together and use this little microphone thing to, you know, talk into and record that audio file and merge that audio file with this screenshot slideshow. And those were like kind of like how my videos were. And just talking about different games, different topics about games, really where I started. So like I did so much of that until one point where I did a lot of that. And then after that, I actually started, you know, having experimenting with the PlayStation Eye on my PS3, using that to, you know, to record my face. I had this like little headset thingy with the fluffy little mic. I did that for a while, and it looks really odd looking back on some of those videos. The audio quality is kind of horrible. It's really odd looking back at some of my older videos. So I did that for a while, and then I eventually started doing playthroughs or let's plays. Wouldn't say they're walkthroughs because I don't have, you know, I'm not really that great at video games to say they're walkthroughs. But it's been interesting to get some comments in which people comment like, "Oh, thank you so much, this was so helpful," which was not the point of those videos. I started doing let's plays and walk and playthroughs because I thought like I wanted to share all the aspects of a single game. And that just kind of, because review is kind of like a summary of like your thoughts on the game. Like, oh, I thought this was good. I thought this was bad. I really enjoyed this part of the game. And just kind of share my thoughts like that. But I really wanted to share my thoughts about all the aspects of the game as it happened. You know, so that's why I did playthroughs. I really enjoyed doing playthroughs in which I commented while playing. It felt like an improv moment. I wasn't very good at it, but I think I improved. To a point, you know, I think if I go back and see, you know, my first playthrough videos and then kind of see more and more and more and more, the later playthrough videos, which I think the last one I ever did was Kirby Epic something. God, what's the name of the game? But it's a Kirby game on the Nintendo Wii. I think that's the latest one I did. Before I did that was the Killzone 3. I think I did really good playthrough on Bakuri Chronicles. That's probably the one I'm really proud of. And then the playthrough I'm the most proud of is, of course, it's not a playthrough because I didn't comment while playing. I commented on the recording of my gameplay footage. Is Flower. It's a game I really love, but I just loved. I think I'm most proud of that project in particular because I interpret, you know, what Flower is saying to gamers, to the players, and what, you know, just my interpretation of Flower as a whole. That was really great, but playthroughs got a little bit tiresome in the end. And I'm not really great playthrough commentator. I'm not funny. I'm not really that funny. I don't really have that much insight. And I'm not a great gamer, you know. I can't really showcase amazing skills as a gamer. So I kind of dropped that for a bit. Especially as, you know, I had a really good setup before I had this MacBook, but then on a PC, I think it was a really great setup, but kind of lost that, and doing it with this setup, with this capture device, it's kind of got a little bit too unwieldy, so I dropped that, and now it's me doing this. I think the first non-gaming video I did was, like, called Kwonmunistic Kwonstein or something like that. That was it's like a slideshow with voice narration, pictures of me holding my cousin's dog. So yeah, that's kind of like the YouTube history. Now it's gotten to this point where I'm just kind of, you know, sharing thoughts in front of the camera, you know, with my face. I think that's the best way to put it. And I think this is a pretty cool project to do, just me talking in front of the camera for an hour every week about different topics. It's, you know, looking back to seeing my progression on this is really interesting. In a way, I think I did get better doing YouTube, blogging at all. I'm still stuttering, like, saying "oh" a lot. So that's something, you know, I think doing this, I see myself improving, and I don't know, it's fun. It's not something that I see myself, like, becoming big. I don't have the YouTube talent for it, I think. I see a lot of... I just recently discovered the channel Daily Grace. Hilarious channel. I'm loving the work that she does. It's kind of what inspires me to do this every week, because she does it 5 days a week. And each day of the week, she has a different theme. Like, Mondays is personal. Tuesdays is where she comments on their video. Wednesdays is where she reviews something in her own way. Thursdays is like her how-to videos. And Friday is, you know, her Sexy Friday, where she gives advice on anything related to love and relationships and sex and stuff. So, you know, that it's really awesome to see how different YouTubers have their personality, their humor, and their creativity behind it, their commitment. I don't see myself, you know, ever getting really to that level on YouTube. It's just something for my personal enjoyment, to have these great YouTube discussions and kind of seeing, like, you know, just kind of archiving my thoughts. I think that's also another way of doing it. The reason why I blog, write a lot is kind of also to that, to share my thoughts. I think I'm a better writer than I'm a talker, than I am a vlogger. That's why I feel like this is a really interesting aspect of doing this. But yeah, those are just some thoughts, I guess. This video in my head was a lot better in my head than how it turned out. But that's usually the case with my YouTube videos, where I just kind of just ramble on without a script. That's also something I think I need to improve on. If I have a script, that it doesn't feel like I'm reading off from it. I think that was probably the biggest thing I noticed about my video, questions a younger me would ask myself. I had a script, and that's the first time in a long time in my YouTube videos where I read from a script. I haven't done that in a long, long, long time, but that's how I started out making YouTube videos. I had a script, I read it, and I recorded that reading of it, and I attached that audio file to a slideshow of pictures. But in the recent past, you know, since 2 years ago or 3 years ago, I record a video just, you know, with the topic in my head, and I just talk about it. And I don't edit it, I just ramble on in front of a camera. It's usually the case for me, but I do feel like having a script and reading off of it can be very powerful, and editing the video can be very useful and could make really strong videos. And I do see instances where I will be doing that. But I think what I need to work on is to make it like, when I'm reading off a script, to make it feel like I'm not reading, but to just be as conversational as I am right now. And that's the challenge, I think, that I have to overcome in my YouTube career. It's not a career because I don't make any money off of it, but I guess it's just the word to use. But yeah, that's been this Hour of Kwonmunism. It's definitely been longer than an hour this time, so that's kind of a first. The previous hours of Kwonmunism have been a little bit over the 1 hour mark or a little bit less, but this time I just went really, just really talkative. So there's that to look forward to. Tomorrow I will be uploading a bunch of different videos and me reading the Bible, and maybe a couple of videos, maybe a video or two, maybe. I'm not promising anything. Me just talking, having a topic on religion and atheism and such, just talking about that. So every Sunday I'll be doing that. Different days of the week, I think I'm going to designate maybe different kinds of videos, but definitely Sundays, religion and any topics related to that. And Saturdays, hoping to do Arab Kwonmunism. The other days of the week, I haven't really determined yet, so anything's up for grabs right now. I think maybe Wednesday I'll talk about gaming. Maybe. Don't know. I feel like this channel is having a new beginning, as I'm kind of just determining the structure of things. So that's that. Hope you enjoyed this Hour of Kwonmunism. You are now more Kwonmunist than you were an hour ago. And yeah, cheers.